games are violent. Really violent.
I don't even think about it.
Holy crap. Really, really violent. Seriously. What? Jeez. Oh, come on. But do they really, really have to be that violent? This game doesn't think so. Don't be so serious. Today we're talking about Death Stranding, one of my favorite games. It's so beautiful, it's super fun, and you don't have to kill a lot of people. Let's get some things out of the way first. This is a beautiful game. It's really well done. It's also deeply original. It's not like any other game out there. As a result, it's not universally loved. That's to be expected. But I love it. I think it's a remarkable work, something worth studying. And that's what we're gonna do here in this video. Let's take a look at the four things that I learned about how they made Death Stranding. That is the key to authorship. To start, this auteur clearly has a mission. Video gamers are notoriously lonely people. I think Kojima actually means this to be nothing less than an actual cure for loneliness.
Living is no different from being dead if you're all alone. I'm on the beach, Sam. Our beach. The one where I was born. Come and find me.
Wow, that's intense. Here's Hideo Kojima himself talking about what he wants this game to mean.
一言で言うと、同じように世界中にそういう人たちがいると思うんですよ。で、ゲームをやってる人は結構そういう人がいると思って、街中ではみんなとワイワイやってたり、するんですけど、やっぱり一人になって、リビングでゲームやってる人って、やっぱり何かしら社会と合わなかったり、コミュニティの中で会わなかったりする人がいると思うんで、ただその人がこのゲームをやった時に、自分みたいな人が世界中にいる、自分は孤独だけど世界中に孤独な人がいっぱいいるっていうのを知ることで、すごいホッとするというか、安心すると思うんですよ。だからそこをゲームで遊んでもらって感じてもらえればいいと思うんですよね。だからそんだけの時間を遊んだ結果、面白かっただけでは済まないと思うので、ゲームの中でバーチャルで体験したものを、リアルな生活の中で役立てるような仕組みにしたかったっていうのが。
Think about the millions of people who are shut away who use video games as a refuge. In Japan, there are people called hikikomori. They're shut-ins who don't interact with anyone, sometimes not even their own parents. The only people they might interact with are the delivery people who bring them food and essentials. It's no mistake that that's primarily what you are. Sam Porter Bridges, a porter who brings disconnected post-apocalyptic cities online. And you are bringing food. You are bringing medicine. You're kind of like a DoorDash delivery person. Kojima doesn't want this to be just another video game. He wants this to change people's lives. A player might spend 50 hours of their life on this one, and the players who get through it, they come out the other end changed. If that's not art, I don't know what is. Here's Norman Reedus at a recent Comic-Con talking about working with him.
It's not a kill-em-all game, it's a bring-people-together game. He's a visionary.
Once you have a direction, it's easy to start surveying, figuring out what's most popular, what's the safe choice. But it's clear that an auteur doesn't do that, and that's not what they did for Death Stranding. Let's take a look.
So our main focus is not on getting as much attention as possible. It's more about trying to develop a character that is interesting for us, and that is cool for us. I'm sure there are studios that focuses developing characters on market research or what's going to be received well out there. But for us, it's more about creating a character that is fun for us while doing it.
That's why an independent approach can often result in way better creative output. whether that's an indie software maker or an indie game developer. When things get big, they get safe, and it often feels safer to outsource your decision-making to a survey, to quantitative thinking. But when you're making something truly this creative, you just can't do it that way. So now you have a direction, and you have a clear way to make decisions. Who actually does the real work? You've got to delegate, but not everything. You've got to hold on to some of the important stuff. Here's a great example of that. Launch day is right around the corner. It's Kojima himself editing the launch trailer.
デス・ストランディング知らない人も世界観とストーリーとゲーム性が分かるような、まあ、メッセージもような分かりやすいやつですね。まあ、どういうトレーラーを作るかを考えて、どこまで情報を出すかっていうのをまず構築しといて、それで曲を選べます。で、普通はロンジトレーラーって映画のスタジオに丸投げして2億ぐらいかけて実写とかプリレンダーのやつを作ります。で、ゲーム作ってる人がこんなことをしてるのは世界に僕だけだと思うんですけど。
Both great founders and true great auteurs know what they can outsource, know what they can give to their own team, and they have an intuitive sense for what they need to do themselves. It's not everything, it's just a few things.Don't get it twisted though, great auteurs are incredible at collaboration. In fact, here's Norman Reedus again, talking about exactly this.
There's like there's certain directors that see a certain scene a certain way, and if you try to add to it, they like short circuit. They're like, Hideo doesn't do that. He's like, yes, and then let's add this. And you're like, yes, and let's add that. And he's like, yes, and add this on top of that. Like,He's cool. He doesn't freak out. You know, his mind is always going forward.
Every creative project ultimately is like this. You need to be able to listen. You need to be able to say yes. You need to be able to incorporate other people's ideas. And only then can you collaboratively create something greater than what you could create individually. Last but not least, I think one thing that's really underrated is how important it is to have the right level of showmanship. This is what happened when Conan O'Brien came over to visit. This is the entryway to their studio.
Oh my God.
Hideo? The twist is, this is how everyone enters the studio.It's exactly the right kind of theatricality. It sets a tone, and any newcomer, anyone who's thinking about joining, any partner, they get to see a side that sets the tone. For an auteur, it's about being different and setting expectations so that your team and everyone around you really treats this as something that could be great, something special. That's in the office,That's in the brand, that's in the design. So we can learn a lot, actually, about auteurship from Hideo Kojima and Death Stranding. First mission, have one, think about what you want to do in the world, what effect you want to have, and orient your whole project around it. Second, make your own decisions. Don't rely on surveys, don't rely on what will be popular.Third, take action. Know what you should do, know what your team needs to do, know what you can outsource. And finally, don't be afraid to be a showman. It takes a little bit of showmanship to do something no one else has ever done.
I'll see you around. Sam Porter Bridges.